What is going on, everybody, and welcome to the channel. Today we are going to the bridge, and we are going to be trying to catch some bridge monsters. Now, earlier I actually went to the beach and caught some ladyfish, and we're going to be using these for bait at the bridge. So, see you guys.
Whoa.
Oh, we got something. What is this? We caught something. Come on, dude, get back over here. Oh, dang it. The heck was that? Guys, well, I'm putting the bait on right now. And we're gonna tighten down this drag and hopefully get us a big fish. Because they're definitely down here. Alright guys, my GoPro died, but I just caught a nice little, or pretty big catfish actually. I bet we're gonna let him go. I figured that might be one of the things out here we could catch. Alright guys, I don't know what's going on with my GoPro, but I literally just caught another one. Doing the same exact thing. But I'm gonna release them real quick and try to figure out what's going on with my GoPro. Alright guys, I don't know what's going on with the GoPro. It's like, I don't know if it's overheating or what. I mean, honestly, I need to get new batteries. I need to get a new GoPro in general because I've been having a lot of issues recently with the GoPro. Because the battery, you know how the batteries work? They have these little like tab you pull on, and I don't know, the tabs have been coming off and they've been getting stuck in the GoPro. You gotta have like a knife or something just to get it out. So I need new batteries, new GoPro. Definitely need to add that to a wish list or something. It's crazy. But hopefully this battery works and we can catch another catfish. I think, I don't know if it was recorded earlier, but I think what happened earlier was there's a whole bunch of catfish going after this thing. And then something bigger came along and grabbed it because whatever that was originally, that thing was huge. Like it was my setup was barely like enough for it, or just enough, but you know, it ran against the rock wall right there. All right guys, I think we got another catfish. Gotta keep you away from that ledge over there. Yeah, it's a catfish. Hard to tell. This might be the biggest one of the day. Alright, let's see, dude. Oh. Started pissing all over me. Well, we only have one more ladyfish bite left, and then we're going to try to catch one more catfish or something, and then what we're going to do is we're going to try to catch them with shrimp fish over here and whatnot, and try to catch more bait, and you know, keep doing the process over and over again. Get some cut bait, throw it out, get cut bait, throw it out, you know, cycle like that. Hey guys, getting another catfish hit. Don't know if he's on there yet. Yep, he's on there. So feels pretty decent. Catfish fight pretty good. They're just yeah, they're catfish. Nothing we really want to catch. Oh, what is this? Oh my god. That's a mangrove snapper. Ha ha. Alright, well, got some dinner. Holy crap. That's a huge mangrove snapper. He is 11. Alright. right, we're gonna put them in the bucket. This is gonna be our dinner. So I only got one more pinfish left. And hopefully we can get another mangrove. I'm trying to catch these small fish, which I assume are probably pinfish and or more mangrove snapper, definitely not the same size. All right guys, just caught a little mangrove on this. Guys, I just had a another huge fish come by. It's like as soon as these big fish get on, they get snagged on something. It's crazy. There we go, another one. It's pretty small, but I mean, it'll work. There we go. Just literally threw this thing into the bridge, and as soon as it pretty much hit the water, went straight down. I was just moving my stuff over. Came along, probably a catfish. Yep. Alright guys, well we are back at the house and we have the mangrove snapper right here. What we're going to do is we're going to make some Cajun mangrove snapper. So what I'm about to do is I'm about to fillet this guy up and we're going to put him in the oven. Now I did measure to get like a final measurement. This guy is actually 11 and a half, which is better than I thought. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and fillet this guy so we can get him cooking. Alright guys, so I have two of the fillets. Now they're not the best fillets in the world because I'm fairly new to this. But anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to stab some holes in it, just a little bit. And we are going to sprinkle our Cajun sauce or spice on it. And then throw it in the oven. Now what I'm doing, or why I'm making holes, are just for the spice to go down into a little bit. Now I'm going to sprinkle this on. Alright, just gonna kinda like push that in a little bit. Alright, now I have the oven on at 375. We're gonna put them in here. Like so, and we're gonna wait, I think about 20 minutes, and should be ready. All right guys, well I am filming this on my phone now because my GoPro just died and I left the batteries in the truck, but anyway, just got the snapper done, and I've had red snapper before but never mangrove, so I'll be interested to see how it tastes compared to the red snapper. All right, mangrove snapper test. It's good. I think I put a little bit too much Cajun on it. It doesn't really have a taste, it just burns. Yeah, I think I overdid it on the Cajun just a little bit. I can't really taste the fish at all, I just taste the spice, which is okay, I like Cajun. But anyway, I'm gonna eat this up. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe, and I will see you guys next week with more fishing content.